we are getting into game number one, the grand finals here in Gdansk. Total Batters against Battleman. We have unloaded Nytos into Deoxys defense.
You just called it, Martijn. 1 second ago, you were talking about this matchup, how it is better than the Medicham in this case. So let's see how we are playing this out. I suppose that Tonton Batus might throw 10 counters before throwing a Thunderbolt.
You may be right, maybe not, but in comes the first Thunderbolt, and it is immediately shielded by Patam, and this will do a lot of damage. You know what I noticed? Both games are not in English, so we really have to look at the animations here. Ice Weather Ball is coming through here. This would do a significant amount of damage. I don't think it would KO yet, but the Charm Fast Attack after definitely would. In comes Gligar, and oh man, Tonton doesn't have a real good answer to this.
Oh, trying to catch an Aerial Ace right here, farming up a lot of energy. But now the Umbreon is going to withstand this dig right here off the Gligar, and it is going to not deal a lot of damage.
Yeah, and I think this is exactly what Patman wants, right? Because he has that Lickitung in the back. But now the Umbreon is aligned to the Gligar, so Lickitung does not have to deal with the Umbreon. This might be really good for him. Foul Play doesn't do as much damage to Gligar too, because Gligar also is quite bulky.
I have news for you. There is a Clefable in the back of Tonton Batus' team, and there is already one shield down for each player, so this makes the Clefable much more useful right here.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's see how this matchup is going to play out. Maybe Tonton doesn't even want the switch advantage if he is expecting the Alolan Ninetales, because this could be such a nice farm down for that Clefable. If you can just take it down only with fast attacks, but I think Batman, yes, going to preserve all that energy, taking the last resort here, but I don't think this will knock it out, Leo.
Oh, this is still going to deal a significant amount of damage. This energy on the Umbreon is well used. Do you switch out immediately into the Deoxys defense? Goes for a counter down, actually takes it. Has a lot of energy right here. This is good momentum for Tonton Batus.
And what do you bring in as Patuman? Because both Pokemon don't really want to take this energy. You can deny everything with the Gligar if you use the Aerial Ace, but then it cannot be used on anything else. But cannot or doesn't throw the charge attack here. In comes a Psycho Boost. It is shielded here by the Gligar. And let's see, I think Patuman wants to preserve all that energy.
Yes, Patoman shields right here. The Deoxys is being let go. No shields used right here. We are going to see a Clefable endgame versus a Lickitung. One shield up. This might be changed relatively soon because there is now going to be a dig connecting right here. Tonton Batus not knowing what the Pokemon in the back is for Patoman. Let's this go. This is the strongest charge attack from Patoman that we are going to see for the rest of this game. Switch timer is going down. We are going to see the Lickitung versus the Clefable right here.
And man, in comes the first Moonblast. This is going to do so much damage. This same type of attack bonus. Moonblast does about 50% almost. Do we get an attack drop? We do not see the attack drop, but man, look at how fast this Clefable paces.
And are we going to see a catch right here? No, we are almost at a Meteor Mash right here. But there is going to be this one shield used from Tonton Batus. The shield advantage that we were talking about so much this weekend. Clefable is an absolute monster with an advantage. We are going to see yet another Moonblast. We have seen how much damage it deals with the first one. So we're going to see it connect. Does it knock out? Yes, it does absolutely knock out!
It does so much damage. And Gligar has no HP left. Tonton takes out this Gligar in game number one.
Oh, that was already a nail biter. We have seen the Clefable go for this shield advantage, little bit of an energy advantage as well. We might see someone checking out this Aerial Ace situation. Mm-hmm. Should have been a charge attack priority with the Deoxys defense. Maybe sometimes the players are reacting too slow and then something else happens. So we're going to check that one out, or we're just going into the next game.
I think it could also be nerfed or another factor, but either way, you have seen the teams from both players now, and is this what we expected? We expected the Deoxys defense because it has a better time against that Alolan Ninetales than the Medicham has. It doesn't take super effective damage from those Charm Fast attacks, right? So now that you've seen both lines, what do you expect here as Tonton Batus? We haven't seen the Seeking. Seeking is pretty okay against that Gligar and the Alolan Ninetales, to be honest, because you have Icy Wind for the Gligar.
You really want to see that Seeking.
I do.
I do understand that. We have seen it earlier in this exact matchup. Tonton Batus versus Patoman. It poisoned, jabbed down the Alolan Ninetales, and that was a really, really strong play, strong choice right there.
Yeah, absolutely. But yeah, Patoman also has the option to adapt, of course. I think Alolan Ninetales has been the best Pokemon for him to use so far, the most used Pokemon. And yeah, I think we're just going to see it every time again. Here we see the achievements from Tonton Bateuse again. He is the European International Champion of 2023, top 10 from World, and many, many other achievements. And perhaps he can add Gdansk to his list as regional champion soon. Or it could be Patoman, who got to this third grand final.
Look at this Liverpool regional finalist, Barcelona special event finalist, Wales competitor with a relatively deep run as well. Yeah. I want to say this was a very strong performance.
Yeah, absolutely. A very strong performance. I think from both sides, in both previous tournaments, he got to the grand finals from the winner's side. This is his first time actually that he came into the grand finals from the loser's bracket, which means he needs to reset the bracket, and it means there might be two best out of fives if Patoman is able to do that.
He was always on the winner's side.
Mm-hmm.
So that means if Patoman is in a grand finals of a regional or a special event, there is a 100% chance of a bracket reset.
I hope so. I mean, that would not be great for Tonton, but man, I would really love some more good battles. How about Julio?
Absolutely, I couldn't agree more. We are seeing our crowd cheering again. Everyone is just waiting. Everyone is hungry to see more of these fantastic trainers, more of these fantastic battles. This was really, really close. I love it when we are seeing those games that are not decided by alignment or any other factor, but just pure skill and making up a game plan in the matter of seconds. If you are in a neutral matchup with some bulky Pokemons, then strategizing in there, you know?
Yeah, and it looks like that we do have a rematch. I think that might be because Patoman was unable to fire that Aerial Ace into the Deoxys defense. So we see a rematch in the first game of the Grand Finals. We saw the lines earlier. We saw the Deoxys defense in the Alolan Ninetales. We saw the Gligar from Patoman, and we saw also the Lickitung from Patoman, right? Because I remember that because he was happy because the Umbreon was not on the Lickitung, was on the Gligar. How do you adapt? Even though this is still a different, going to be a different game, it's going to be new teams likely, or they agree on same teams. You have seen how your opponent plays this first game. Even though it is technically the first game, you can still adapt, right? So there's already a lot of thoughts going through these players. I think the main thought here is, how am I going to protect my fairy?
Yeah, I think the main thought for Patoman is going to be, how do I keep my shields up? Because this fairy was rampaging. We have seen a Lickitung losing a neutral matchup.
Yeah.
Easily. Clefable had a lot of HP after this. Of course, it had a shield up.
It had a shield. It had
But those Moonblasts,
they chunk.
Oof.
They do a lot of damage. They're blasting away.
Yeah, with the strength of the moon, I want to say. But this is going to be an incredibly exciting game once again. We have already seen one game. We get to see more Pokemon Go action. And those trainers. You know what I really like about Patoman's team?
Tell me.
Like, I couldn't talk about it this weekend. I just never said anything about it. I love that he's using Umbreon and Lickitung. Both of these Pokemon have been used as safe swaps a lot. Both of these Pokemon are incredibly bulky and so strong in neutral situations. And you've seen it multiple times in the last regionals or special events or ICs even. When you get one of those Pokemon in, sometimes it's not safe. Against some teams, these Pokemon just aren't safe swaps and then you have to adapt. You can just bring both and you're always going to have a safe swap there.
It's true. I must say though, pairing those two Pokemon can be very difficult if you face a Registeel. I think Registeel will be an absolute menace against Patoman's team. Oh, luckily, there is none of those for him right now. There is, in fact, no Steel type on Tonton Bateuse's team to deal with. And I think that works very well for Patoman here. And again, that Umbreon is just so safe as long as it's not on that Clefable. And because it's Deoxys defense instead of Medicham, Umbreon's even better. Here we go. We have the rematch. Tonton Bateuse versus Patoman. We have the same teams. Actually, no, it's not the same teams. We have the Artibax here instead of the other Pokemon that Tonton Bateuse had.
And the Arctivax is just so jolly about not having to face this Shadow Alolan Ninetales that is charming down on the Deoxys defense. We're going to see the first Thunderbolt being shielded already. So Patoman already keen on investing those shields. And Clefable is just rubbing its hands against each other.
Yeah, exactly. Those small hands from Clefable ready to rub the hands together for those Moonblasts later. But first, we have this matchup to play out. And it looks like Patoman is doing a similar thing, going into the Gligar right away and answered by the Artifex. This is somewhat of a good matchup because you are that ice type, but that means you have to build all the way to the Avalanche. Both players building up energy. Patoman likely going to shield this attack, I think, because you have so much energy, right?
Shields down completely already. The Clefable in the back is really happy about that. But you're still going to have to build up some kind of advantage. You still have to be good with letting go this dig of the Gligar right here. This is going to be massive damage on the Arctibex. Arctibex cannot get to another attack. No, we are immediately throwing the Aerial Ace.
Yeah, flipping the switch advantage here. I don't know if that's what you want as Patoman. Now you have Leaky Tongue likely on the Deoxys defense. But man, we've seen Clefable with a shield advantage. And here is that Clefable. Shield advantage might disappear very soon, however. In comes that Aerial Ace, and it's no-shooted by Tontobatus, who's been counting very carefully.
And I find this really interesting, because Aerial Ace is not going to deal the biggest amount of damage, and now you're going to be able to get so much energy onto this Clefable. Now the switch into the Licky Tang, and we're going to see Moonblasts!
Yeah, now both players have revealed their Pokémon to each other, and this leaves Tonton to see if he wants to stay in or swap into Deoxys at some point. I think he's just going to fire another Moonblast after shooting up this Body Slam. Now all shields are down. Body Slam does not deal any damage. Well, one damage through the shield, but this allows Clefable to farm up more energy.
Oh yes, and we are dangerously getting low with the Clefable just to the licks. There would be a little bit more time until there is a Body Slam, but we want to preserve some health right here. Going to knock out.
Barely.
No! Another Fairy Wind coming in. Barely not knocking out the Lickitung, but that's history now. The Lickitung is knocked out. We are almost at an attack again for the Clefable.
Both and this is so tough for Patoman because there's also energy. Oh man, here comes the... Is this time?
Is this time?
I think this is double super effective. Meteor Mage is being charged. Up here we go!
Boom! There goes the Alolan Ninetales, and we're going to see a combo play from Tontobatus right here. He's switching in the Deoxys defense immediately, going for the Psycho Boost. It is going to connect. There are no shields remaining. Gligar hangs on with the thrust.
And Aerial Ace is coming through. No, not coming through. Counter down, and Tontobatus taking game number one against Patoman.
Wow, very strong, unfazed after this game one. This is such a peak performance from both of those players. Patoman using a shield early, and then I think another one on the Gligar. Of course, you don't want to get another avalanche collected on the Gligar.
Yeah, and looking at the change that Tonton made there, he went for that Artifex instead of the Umbreon that he brought in game two, in the first game. Now he went for Artifex because he expected the Gligar. It is somewhat of his best answer. I think that Tonton's team kind of struggles with Gligar, but he managed to play so smart with his Pokemon. Knows when he needs to shield and when he doesn't need to shield, when he needs to switch and when he doesn't need to switch. Tonton is making all those right calls, and that really comes with that skill as a former European international champion.
So that was one situation in which I disagreed with Patoman's place. I'm pretty sure that Patoman has chosen the correct line there, but I still want to discuss it.
Tell me.
So, it was Gligar versus Clefable, and Patoman went for the Aerial Ace, just not getting to that dig, but throwing the Aerial Ace before the Clefable was able to throw a Meteor Mash. So, if you just throw the dig at charge attack priority, you get this Clefable energy dry.
Yeah. The problem is, though, Clefable wins the charge attack priority. Yep. So I think what Patoman was afraid of, my opponent is counting, he is good, he's smart, he's good at the game, he played the Go Battle, he hit Legend, he knows when I'm at that charge attack, so he wins it, right? I think that's why he went for the Aerial Ace. But here we go, Leo. We have game number two. We have Umbreon into Alolan Ninetales. This is perfect for Patoman.
Would you look at that? And what do you even switch into this? You're switching in the Gligar after taking one charm already. We are going to throw some wing attacks. This is Ice types versus Gligar again, part two.
Yeah, and the charms don't do as much as the Power Snow, but this Wettable would definitely take out an entire family of Gligar. It's a charge attack priority. This ground type charge attack is going to do so much damage on Alolan Knights as well. And Batman puts up the Protect Shield.
And you know this is a double-edged sword protecting against anything that isn't named Clefable. We're going into the Gligar Mirror match right now. Very smart play by Patoman. Heads up play from him here. He's going to be able to take so many aerial aces and retaliate with about one or two.
Yeah, and this aerial ace won't do too much damage. Gligar can take it, but you know, the energy coming out of this, I don't think it's going to be super valuable against that Umbreon. Losing the charge attack priority, I mean, rumor has it that shiny Pokemon have higher attack. In this case, it actually does. Aerial Ace goes through, and Batoman kind of wasting that energy. It would have been more advantage to throw it before the previous Aerial Ace, but regardless, has so much energy still going into the next matchup. It doesn't even knock out just yet.
Yeah, so it is actually the correct choice to throw it then and not already before that. So there is the info about the charge attack priority. So we are going to throw a dig. Umbreon is such a bulky Pokemon. We have seen so many times that this does about 20%. Umbreon takes it like a champ and is going to throw a foul play after one Snarl.
Yeah, foul play is going to take out the Gligar. And man, Leo, have you seen what's in the back there? Batoman has had it with this Clefable. It comes Clefable. There is the Venusaur. Venusaur is a hard wall to this Clefable. Meteor Mash is still a very strong charge stack. I think it still will do a good chunk here, but on even shields, the Venusaur will have a very good matchup here. As you see, Meteor Mash still chunks very hard. Fairy Winds, however, are resistant. They don't chunk, but a Sludge Bomb, this will definitely do a lot of damage to the Clefable. We see the Protect Shield on the Clefable coming up.
And now what a call from Patoman, because as a Shadow Venusaur, if you're behind on energy, these Meteor Mash deal a lot more damage. And I think at this point, even a Frenzy Plant would be very close to knocking out that Clefable. So we might actually not see Sludge Bombs after this one anymore.
In fact, I think it will knock out the Frenzy Plant. It looks like Patoman is going for the Frenzy Plant here. This is a higher attack Pokemon than Superior, so the Frenzy Plant hit even harder. Frenzy Plant coming through, and you're about to get to another one on the Umbreon. I mean, at this point, it's very tough for Tauntaun. He needs so much energy, yeah. But Frenzy Plant's already coming through.
Patoman charging up that Frenzy Plant from the Venusaur. The OG Frenzy Plant user going for a charm right here. Tauntaun is not able to reach another charge attack. Wouldn't matter anyway. This is so much health on the Alolan Ninetales, and we are having a 1-1 for ourselves.
Yeah, tying up the score here. Patoman very well played, and also predicting that Clefable, Leo, he has had it. He's had it with Clefable. It's too good. It had its spotlight. And Tauntaun said he will bring it about every game anyway. So I'm just going to bring the Venusaur. Like, come on, bring your Clefable. I don't care. There's the Venusaur. And Venusaur was so good against Clefable. Yeah, right? The Vine Waves just added up. And the charge attacks are just so good. The Sludge Bomb almost knocks out that Clefable in one charge attack.
You bring me a very unique Fairy-type meta, Colin. I will raise you a Poison-type Pokémon. What a great performance by Patoman. And I want to look at the team of Tauntaun Batuus again to see how risky bringing that Venusaur actually was.
I don't think it really is, to be honest. Obviously, the Psycho Boost from the Deoxys defense will deal super effective damage. It will do a big chunk, but it's not the worst. And if Deoxys will use that Psycho Boost, it will drop its attack stat by two stages, so that means that the counters afterwards will do less. Or if you shoot the first Psycho Boost, the next ones will do less. What we also have is that Artabax and the Gligar. I think there is some risk, but there's also four Pokemon that the Venusaur has some really, really good play against.
That is true. And as with all of those very offensive Pokemon, most of the rather worse matchups can actually be flipped, and the keyword for that is energy or shield advantage. And if you are able to get this on a Venusaur, especially on a Shadow Venusaur, sometimes you have seen this with Zweilus already in the Barcelona finals. This can be key to winning that matchup, but we're going to see.
Whoa, it's the flying type into the ice type, but this is not the worst for Gligar, and Pataman is staying in this matchup. He would have loved to have his Alolan Nidus on this, though. This is so risky from Tonton Bateuse. We see both Pokemon charging up energy here, going for the first ground type charge attack, and it's no shoot by Tonton Bateuse. This will do a lot of damage.
Yes, this is absolutely massive. Now, I can imagine that Pataman is just going to go for a shield right there. This might also be a Dragon Claw bait. He does call it. It is the Avalanche into the shield.
Yeah, this would have taken out an entire family of Gligar as well. Actually, we've seen that before. Going into Dinos, trying to take it out with one charm, but unable to. A quick swap from Tonton Bateuse into the Deoxys defense. And I don't know if this is the switch he wanted to make, because you have that Sea King in the back. Thunderbolt is going through. I don't think this knocks out, but this puts the Alolan Nidus very, very low.
Yeah, Sea King would be absolutely fantastic against the Shadow Alolan Ninetales. Shadow Alolan Ninetales has a little bit of an energy advantage right there. It can go for one Weather Ball right here. And also, there's one thing that you don't like going. Oh, there is a shield on this Deoxys defense.
Yeah, he wants to keep that Deoxys alive here. And Deoxys counters down the Alolan Ninetales. Going for the Psycho Boost right away. The Gligar was not at an Aerial Ace just yet, but it might be able to wing attack down, because now the counters will do less damage from the Deoxys.
Yep, I still like this play, because otherwise you lose all of your energy to an Aerial Ace. And we are going for a charge attack priority. Perfect counting by Pataman again as well, getting rid of this Deoxys, still having a lot of energy on this low HP Gligar. So it is going to be very useful still. We are going to charge up some Dragon Claws. There is the Aerial Ace. Will it knock out the Arctibex as well? No, it is going to be shielded right here. This Arctibex is supposed to come to get to another attack. It is going against the Lickitung. Avalanche is thrown right here.
Yeah, and this is actually really tough, because now, oh, the Avalanche is no shield, however, this will do a ton of damage. But the Lickitung has a Grass-type charge attack. Pataman is looking like, ooh, there's a fish. I'm going to use my Grass-type charge attack on that. Gets there right before the Ice Wind can potentially debuff this Power Whip. But this will do so much damage, because Seeking is quite fragile. Here we go. Boom. Whip does so much damage there.
Yes, and now we're going for an Icy Wind right here, but it doesn't matter. Pataman still has one shield reserved just for this Seeking VIP shield right here. We are going for more Licks and Gold King. Sorry, Seeking, that was the German name, is charging fast, but not fast enough. And we're going to see a Lick down right here. Body Slam is going to connect onto the Arctibex, and Pataman gets to the lead.
Game number three goes to Pataman. He's one battle off that bracket reset. What happened twice to him so far? Now he might be able to do it himself to get that bracket reset. That would be great for Pataman, not so great for Tonton. And Tonton can still prevent that, but he needs to get two wins in a row now. That's not easy against Pataman, right?
Yeah.
He's using the Charm Alolan Ninetales perfectly so far. The Gligar has been so good, even against that Ice-type Arctibex. Arctibex just doesn't counter it well enough there, and Gligar just paces so fast.
Yes, you would think, hey, maybe this is an Ice Fang Arctibex, because then this matchup would be significantly better for the Arctibex. But unfortunately, after you have handed in your team sheet, you can't just
TM
your Pokemon anymore.
Yeah, you cannot change that, so it is the Dragon Breath artifacts that we have here. And we saw Seeking, but I think it would have been in a better position if Tonton aligned it to that Charm Alolan Ninetales. But I also think Tonton just made a quick reflex there, because the Charm Alolan Ninetales came in and he just had to swap immediately. Otherwise, the artifacts was just gone, knocked out. And that way, Tonton did preserve the artifacts, but I don't think he had the matchup he wanted with the Deoxys into that Alolan Ninetales.
Pokemon Go is still also a game of reaction, and sometimes you can't make the right choice if you just... The human brain can only react so fast, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And we also saw like the Power Whip going on the Seeking. It just shows that Seeking is very versatile, but also it is quite fragile, because that did so much damage. I think it did about 70% damage to the Seeking. Didn't knock out just yet, but it did put it into the red. And I think if you had Deoxys in that spot, you didn't really need to Like nothing from the Lickitung does as much damage as the Power Whip on the Seeking. So that also misput the shield a little bit there. Imagine you land the Avalanche and then you come with the Deoxys, you have so much counter damage still.
Yep, that is true. And also the charged attacks deal a sizable chunk against the Lickitung. And now we're going to see Patoman versus Tonton Bateau's number 4 on this Grand Finals. And we're going to see Psychic versus Poison.
Yeah, but is this really Psychic? Yes, it is defensively. But offensively, it only has Psycho Boost. And while this is super effective, it also drops your attack by 2 stages. Going in with that Psycho Boost here. Does Patoman shield this, or does he think this is a Thunderbolt? He boosts up the protection shield against a super effective charge attack.
Very well played, but this is, oh, we're going still for the charge attack priority. A Frenzy Plant is going to connect. It is going to actually hit the Deoxys defense for a lot of damage already, and I can imagine that this Psycho Boost is not going to deal too much damage on the Venusaur. However, this Venusaur has no positive matchups against Tonton Batuza's team. There is Gligar and there is Umbreon.
Yeah, Umbreon is okay, but Gligar is very tough to deal with. You know what I also noticed? Ever since Patoman brought the Venusaur, we haven't seen Clefable anymore.
Yeah, that is true. Where is Clefable right now? Can you find it real quick?
It's on the bench.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to see Gligar versus Lickitung. We have seen this more than one time today. The beautiful shiny blue Gligar is going to charge up the first charge attack here.
Yeah, Dick is coming through on this Lickitung. Does a chunk of damage, but Lickitung can take it. And it's almost at 2 body slam, but the Gligar is already at his next ground type charge attack here.
This body slam is going to connect, and we're going to see some more wing attacks. We have Dig already. We have double aerial ace, and we're going for the first aerial ace. Does Patoman invest a shield? No, he does not. He's already down one, and there could still be a Clefable in the back.
Yeah, and I think he knows he will barely survive that. Going for the body slam here, this will definitely take out. And then a full aerial ace is just wasted from that Gligar, but you might get another a farm down on any of your Pokemon here. In comes the Umbreon, and Umbreon, I think, is in an okay spot. It has the time and the momentum to gain energy on this Lickitung.
Yeah, but even though the licks barely add up, there will be like 20 body slams if you try to farm down. However, we are immediately going into another neutral Gligar matchup right here. Umbreon is going to throw the first foul play.
I wonder how this is going to go, because you need so many foul play into this Gligar. There's still one shield up on both sides. There's still a little bit of that Venusaur on Patoman's side. First ground type charge attack is going through, not going for the bait, and an immediate no shield from Tonton Bateau's. This will do significantly more than the aerial ace.
Tonton Batuu's possibly going for a wrong call with his shield right here, going for a last resort immediately. And that is interesting. Possibly counted that he will just get to another Snarl as well before he could go for 2 foul plays. But we are going to see another Dig right here. And it is no shielded as well.
Oh, interesting. I think this barely won't knock out. Batman still has a shield. Deoxys is so low. In comes a foul play. Can Umbreon pull through here? There's still a little bit of Deoxys defense left as well, but I don't think it has energy. Foul play comes through, takes out the Gligar. It's now Venusaur into Deoxys. And oh man, Deoxys just doesn't have a lot of HP here, Leo.
Yes, both players have one shield remaining. We are seeing a swap, a lick combo play into the Lickitung. Lickitung is also going to be able to lick down the Umbreon. And this is the bracket reset!
Patoman still has a chance here to win it. He is now even with Tonton Bateau's. Both players have defeated each other at least once. And now we are going to get another best out of 5. Chat, let me know. Now the field is even. Who do you think is going to take this battle? Is it Tonton Bateau's or is it Patoman?
Patoman just seems unstoppable at this tournament. You have seen it. Both players have defeated each other 3-1, 1 time already. And after he won this game, there was no big celebration. You know, there is something coming up, but it was a nod of confidence into the camera, and that is what I like to see.
Peak Patoman seems very focused right now. Resetting the bracket gives so much confidence going into the next best out of 5. And Tonton, I think Tonton is in a very tough spot right now. The losing 3-1 in that Grand Finals is a very rough spot to be in. And you can see him, it is tough for him. However, he still has that chance. And he doesn't have a bad matchup here per se. Maybe we need to bring back that Clefable. The Clefable worked for him in that game number 1. But that Gligar from Patoman just seems so strong as well.
Yes, Gligar is an absolute MVP here in this game. And now what Tonton Batuu needs is not a bracket reset. I mean, he got that already, but a mind reset. So this is just another best of five. This is a completely new game. You have defeated Patoman already. You can do it again. This is a new game. It is 0-0. You are not down 3-1.
And I think the same can be said for Patoman here, because it's a new game for him as well, and he also has to make a good prediction on what Tonton will use. We see here the crowd. Can we get some hype here? I see. Come on, Savage Boy. Yes, yes, thank you, Arceus already. Yes, thank you. Give me that hype.
There we are, our beloved crowd already. Alejandro in the back there as well. We're seeing multiple players that have been popping up in those turns. Popping, talking about popping up. There is Arceus already playing a little mini game with Savage Boy.
Yeah, indeed. And yeah, here we see the players again. Again, let's take a look at this team's Leo, because we haven't seen the Clefable from Tonton Batuu once we saw Patoman bring out the Venusaur. He was just sick of Clefable. Clefable, that happy little fairy, was just dancing around with those fairy winds and just throwing those moon blasts around. And then Patoman came with the Venusaur. We haven't seen the Clefable ever since. Do you think we will see Clefable return in this next matchup?
Yes, I think so. Someone would have to tell me exactly how this matchup goes, because those Meteor Mashes can connect for a lot of damage, so energy advantage or shield advantage might help there. We are seeing a tale as old as time. Deoxys defense versus Shadow Alolan Ninetales in this game one of the Winners Finals reset.
Yeah, and this is a story we've seen before. We saw this in game number one of the previous best out of five. Deoxys into Alolan Ninetales. We know how this goes. Deoxys going for the Thunderbolt. Again, Patoman putting up the shield here. This would put the Alolan Ninetales very low.
Yes, thrown after 10 counters. Perfect timing right here. We are seeing one charm coming out. And is this going to get out another shield? No, it's not. This weather ball is going to connect. It barely does not take out. Oh, the charm knocks out the Deoxys defense before it can throw the Psycho Boost.
Yeah, not being able to get to the last Psycho Boost here. Staying in with that Alolan Ninetales here. And that's, oh, getting to another weather ball. This Alolan Ninetales is putting in so much work. But Tonton is probably just happy that this Artifact is not alive. Oh, never mind. It's still possible because Lickitung joins the party. And this is so tough for Tonton, because now the Alolan Ninetales is still alive and your Artifex is still threatened by it.
All I see is pink, not anymore. Artifex is joining the party now as well. And this is a positive matchup for the Artifex of Tonton Batuu. It can charge up a lot of energy because one Moonblast already connected a lot of damage. And you will have to exit this matchup with a lot of energy to withstand the charms of the Shadow Alolan Ninetales.
I think you need to like Dragon Breath it all the way down. You need so much energy to take down that Alolan Ninetales that likely will come back in. Boots up the Protect Shield here. Shields are down on Tonton's side, but can you get the Dragon Breath down on this Lickitung? It's a very bulky Pokemon, but you need to avalanche it. Take out it. It does Lickitung get there.
No!
Lickitung gets there. Oh, this is devastating for Tonton and great for a Patoman. Body Slam coming through and will take out this Artifex with almost 100 energy.
Oh, this is so much energy that is just lost here. We get two Fairy Winds in with the Clefable, but it is Clefable against the world. There is a full health Gligar in the back. Patoman is looking to make this a 1-0 already in the Grand Finals reset. Tonton Batuu is just going for Fairy Winds right now, and this is 1-0 for Patoman!
What a smart play from peak Patoman here. That Alolan Ninetales winning the lead, then swapping in the Lickitung to preserve that Alolan Ninetales and putting out so much pressure on that Artifex from Tonton. This is such a tough position from Tonton. Tonton basically always wants to bring something that can deal with that Gligar. And even though Gligar wasn't there even, Patoman didn't even need the Gligar. The combination of Alolan Ninetales and Lickitung was just so strong. That just the presence of Gligar is so strong, right? It just forces that Artifex to come out every time, and that makes the Alolan Ninetales so strong.
Yes, Alolan Ninetales. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. We have talked about this before. This might be the call for this event. Even better than the Shadow Steelix. Arguably more successful. We have seen less of it in the top eight, but we have seen more of it in the Grand Finals. We have two fairy types that are surpassing three big Shadow Steel types.
I mean, I don't want to talk bad about Steelix, but like it lost twice to Alolan Ninetales.
Yeah.
So maybe Alolan Ninetales. This is the Alolan Ninetales show. It's not the Steelix gaming show. It's the charm show. This is a very charming battle.
honestly, at this point, with all those dragon tails and breaking swipes, is Steelix even a steel type, or is it a dragon type, and that's why it's losing to the fairies?
It is a dragon attacker mostly right now, unless you have Thunder Fang on it, then it has a little bit of different coverage. But right now, there is no Steelix anymore in the tournament remaining. We have two fairies instead, and the Alolan Ninetales definitely has been very dominating. For those just tuning in, we are in the grand finals. Patoman has reset the bracket early against Tonton Mateus. Both players have played each other twice now, in the winner's final first, then in the previous grand final, and now in the last, in the bracket reset of that grand final, we have another best out of five where Patoman is leading 1-0. Patoman has all the ingredients to cook a victory here. He is cooking, Leo!
Let him cook. Patoman is in the advantage. He won 4 games in a row.
Yeah.
What is his recipe for this? Tonton Mateus will have to figure it out soon. Otherwise, with 2 more games won by Patoman, he has been stolen the title of the champion, and Patoman might have achieved his first.
Yeah, this really reminds me of Barcelona, right? Where Zuilos at some point won 4 battles in a row against Patoman, and then Patoman lost the fortune.
Oh.
Now he's in a better position, especially, well, not with this lead actually, but again, we have the Charmeloan Nidus in a position somewhere. Let's see how Patoman is going to play this out, because this is a very favorable lead for Tonton Mateus.
Yes, this is absolutely phenomenal, but Patoman has this Gligar that he brought again and again, and it is relatively unanswered by Tonton's team. If you're looking closely, this is super safe against him.
Yeah, absolutely. Lickitung only doesn't have a good matchup here against that Umbreon. Against everything else on Tonton Mateus' team, it has a rather decent matchup, I would say. But let's take a look on how both players are going to stay in. The fact that Patoman stays in tells me he's either going to switch out with a lot of energy, because again, the Gligar is also very safe, or he's just going to get an energy advantage on whatever he has in the back. And he indeed brings in that Gligar again. Tonton Mateus just doesn't have a strong answer though. So what do you do here? Do you just stay in with that Umbreon?
I mean, you have a big energy advantage. However, 2 body slams and the licks coming with it have dealt a lot of damage on the Umbreon as well. So this might be actually favorable for Patoman right here, and he might be able to flip the switch, even though he has lost a significant chunk of health on the Lickitung as well as the Gligar right now. Look at those health bars.
Yeah, look at that smart play from Tonton Mateus, recognizing he needs 2 last resorts here. Last resort does a little bit more damage than the foul play, and 2 last resort might barely be enough to knock out the Gligar. I think an area ace won't be enough here. Oh man, last resort is going through. Is this going to knock out the Gligar?
We are going to see if it is being shielded. No!
Oh, it doesn't knock out. Gligar hangs on and goes for the final charge attack here. What does Tonton come in with now? He has that Deoxys, he has that Sea King. Both can get that energy here. And Deoxys just has so much neutral play. There's no Umbreon on Patoman's side, and both Lickitung and Alolan Ninetales have a rather neutral matchup here.
Yeah, let's see if he brings in the Lickitung. That means that the Golking is going to be on the Shadow Alolan Ninetales. This looks good for Tonton Mateus. The Umbreon has done so much work. It did not only take out the Gligar, it has also taken 60% of the Lickitung, and we know how hard it is to take 60% of a Lickitung. That's like a Charizard Blast Burn.
Yeah, and this is what Patoman has been doing the whole time, throwing weak charge attacks and then going 2 shields on the final Pokemon. Look at this, Charmeloan Ninetales against Poison Jab Seeking, seeking for the win here, going for the Icy Wind to stop those charms, because look at that, the charm is doing more than the super effective Poison Jab.
Charm is just such a powerful attack, and Seeking is dancing its way to victory right here. We are getting 2 more Poison Jabs in now before this Weather Ball is falling down. So this is going to be shielded.
Yeah, this would put the, it would put the Seeking very low. That ice would really help. Can you take down this Alolan Ninetales? It is a simultaneous KO. Now it comes down. Who will take down each other's final Pokemon? Because both deal super effective damage on each other. And look at that. Tonton getting the 2 Psycho Boosts. Patoman already has 1 body slam, but letting it go. This Psycho Boost going through. And it means Tonton Mateus ties the score up by 1-1.
Wow, what a heartbeat final this is. Tonton Mateus breaking this course finally. Oh, we are seeing more of those players in our fantastic community right here. Everyone is super excited about this finals. This is 2 giants.
Wow, look at Alejandro, Jojo Gogo Dancer. We have a lot of familiar names in the crowd here. We have number one hype man, Arceus Aurelius as well in the crowd. And they're all looking at this fantastic, fantastic grand finals that we have here. Both players are absolute masterminds. They have the ingredients to get those wins, but you need to make a good meal. You need to cook a good dinner to, you know, get to cook a good grand finals.
Yes, and Tonton Batu's won without Clefable. The way to go was Sea King, even though the Sea King actually had a simultaneous KO with the Shadow Alolan Ninetales. If it didn't KO, this would have been such a crazy good spot for Tonton Batu's.
This is the way. No Clefable. Yeah. Or maybe it is, I don't know. But he also hasn't brought the Venusaur Batman, right? So maybe that does lead Tonton to bring that Clefable again. But if there's also no Umbreon, it's not really a hard target for the Clefable. We haven't seen any Medicham at all from Batman. Usually his MVP for every tournament, as far as I know. He loves using Medicham, relies on it a lot. But not in this matchup. He really fears that combination of Deoxys, Clefable, and Gligar.
So it is crazy that we haven't seen that much Arctobex from Tonton Batu's if we haven't even seen Medicham once. Now we're going into game three. Who takes the lead in this grand finals bracket reset? We have the ice type against Gligar. However, this is a charm using Pokemon. This is not going to be about those powerful Weather Ball ice types.
Yeah, Weather Ball will definitely take. Oh, going straight for the ground type charge deck here. But if Batuman is Batuman, he usually double shields here in the lead. He's going to put up a protection. Yes, Batuman is Batuman, and putting up that shield on his beloved Charmer Pokemon. Going for that perfect timing here on that Ice Weather Ball. If Tonton wants to get another charge deck off, he has to put up the Protect Shield here, which he does.
This is looking crazy good for Batuman right there, because he can just shield this up again and easily farm down a lot of energy.
Yeah, absolutely. The Alolan Ninetales just is such a strong Pokemon for Batman because it basically defeats about every single Pokemon from Tonton if you use those two shields, and they have so much energy for the next Pokemon coming in as well. Batman doing the same again, swapping in that Lickitung, putting Tonton in such a rough spot, because what do you do with your Arctobex now? Yes, there is Gligar in the back, but there's also still that Alolan Ninetales.
Yes, what we're doing is charging up at least two Psycho Boosts on the Deoxys defense, throwing one, and I'm pretty sure that we're going to see some nice Arctobex play right here. Arctobex going in there. Unfortunately, the attack of Lickitung is not debuffed. That was the Deoxys defense, and we're going to see some Body Slams right here. Those are dealing a lot of damage for a Body Slam, and this is number two.
Yeah, this is very tough for Tonton. I think he knows it's that. I mean, he needs that energy for the Alolan Ninetales, and I think he's still dreaming of landing that double avalanche. Is he able to? Like, I don't know how much energy you get from this matchup as well. Body Slam coming through. You have to use your final protection here. But how far is the clock? Can this charm Alolan Ninetales take down this Arctobex with one fast attack? The clock is almost up for Batuman.
Oh, and we are not going to. We are going
to. Oh! The play here, swapping in that Alolan Ninetales, denying all the energy, all of Tonton's work in this match is for nothing.
Combo play right here. We are going to see the Deoxys defense trying to charge up more energy. It's going to go for a Thunderbolt because, yes, Psycho Boost is a lot cheaper, but if you're going to throw that one, you have no chance of winning the last matchup in there. You don't know what the last Pokemon is that Batuman is bringing. It is a Gligar. This is looking grim for Tonton Batu's in game number three. We stop tapping those counters. Aerial Ace is going to connect. Tonton Batu's already wants to focus on the next game, but Batuman gets the lead!
Wow, 2-1 here from Batuman in the bracket reset. First winning 3-1, now he's up 2-1 against Tonton Batu's. Batuman is getting closer and closer to finally getting that number one spot here, Leo. Is this the day of peak Batuman?
Oh, you have said this a lot over the weekend, so I think it has to be at this point. Batuman with an incredible performance. It is absolutely not easy to reverse sweep a bracket in the grand finals.
Absolutely.
But it has been done to Batuman twice, and this Spanish boy says, this is not going to happen to me again. I'm not going to get second place again. So he is one game away from a victory.
It's just so difficult for Tonto Bateuse, I think, because the charm alone of Ninetales wins about everything in the lead, with, as long as you have shields on bottom. And at the start of the game, you have all your shields. So that really works. You know what I also find very iconic about this matchup here? Bateuse basically has been in this chair, in Tonto's position, against Zweilous in Barcelona. He had the bracket reset against him, coming in from that winner's side. And then Zweilous won four games against him in a row. And Zweilous basically run off with that victory win in Barcelona. But now it might be Bateuse's turn to do the same. He learned from Zweilous, maybe.
Yes, everyone can learn from Zweilous, one of the most knowledgeable players in the community. I would also say he's pretty good. And Bateuse is really good as well, because every time Bateuse shows up at a tournament, he just runs through it.
Yeah, absolutely. Bateuse is just unstoppable so far in this matchup, right? And in about every tournament that he played, really. Again, Bateuse got to top two 3 times now, including this one. But this one can be that number one, finally. And that is like in every tournament he plays, except Worlds, that's where he got the top 24. But all the other regional championships, he always is runner-up. But this might be that one tournament. This might be gold for him.
Bateuse wants to finally claim this throne of Europe, and Tonton Batou still wants it back. He has managed to beat Bateuse one time already in this tournament. He has won 2 games over the course of this double best of 5. Can he do it again? Can he win 2 games in a row? It seems reachable as well, but you cannot trip up once more.
I think that Tonton is going to bring that Seeking again. That charm alone, Ninetales in the lead, is just so difficult to overcome. Even with Gligar pacing so fast, you can get the 3 aerial A's. The aerial A's won't do enough damage, but if you try to go for the ground type charge attack, it just doesn't deal, and it gets shielded, you don't get 2 more charge attacks. So that's the difficult spot that Tonton is in. It's so difficult to overcome that charm alone, Ninetales in this position.
I absolutely agree with you. The only problem with Seeking in the lead is that if you don't face the Alolan Ninetales, you might be in trouble. We're seeing Shadow Alolan Ninetales versus Gligard. We have seen this so many times already. We know how this one rolls out.
Yeah, well, it also depends on which charge attacks Bateuse shields. I think when it comes to Alolan Ninetales, Bateuse just shields everything.
Yeah, but this has been his play for so long now, but does he anticipate an aerial ace bait? Finally, no, he shields that one up as well.
Yeah, exactly. But that was only 5 wing attacks. Are you able to get to 2 more? It will be very close. I think you barely might be able to. Ice Wettable coming in. Tonton Bateuse wants to get some more shields here. And let's see, putting up that protect shield because he wants to protect the Gligar.
The question is, oh, we are seeing an immediate switch right here. Gligar, after 1 wing attack, gets hit with the aerial ace. And now Tonton Bateuse is free to choose which Pokemon he is going to bring in. And it is going to be the Clefable.
Yeah.
With a little bit of an energy disadvantage. The shields are even. Is Clefable able to win this? Because the damage lead is just there. Moonblast is going to be charged up. This is not a bait. Bateuse will have to shoot this if he wants to prevail his Gligar.
Whoa! Wow, Moonblast lands, and oh, the first attack drop of the day from the Moonblast, going for the ground type charge attack here. And now this does less damage on that Clefable. You might be able to tank, you definitely tank 1. Do you tank 2 now? I think you do. That might be crucial here, Leo.
Oh, this is really close. I think it would barely knock out, but we will find out in just a second. The dig is going to connect on the Clefable, and it tanks one!
Oh my, not having to use a shield here is fantastic. Oh man, he's so close to a medium edge, but barely getting licked down by the Lickitung. In comes that Deoxys, and this is a very neutral matchup. Oh man, this is going to get so close. Gligar has so much energy. There's still a healthy Alolan Ninetales. Both Pokemon are charging up so much energy here, but in comes that first body slam from Bateuse.
Yes, and I can safely say that this won't be shielded. Deoxys' defense is standing there, very bulky, a lot of energy, and it is going for the first Thunderbolt. We are not going to see a Psycho Boost and then a switch out into the other Pokemon immediately, into the very low Gligar with a lot of energy. It is going to connect. Oh, we're going to see a switch into the Gligar as well. Gligar is going out of the Aerial Ace right now.
I think this is actually quite good for Bateuse. Going, this Aerial Ace is going through, but it might not knock out. Does it knock out? It does not. Lickitung hangs on. In comes a little Ninetales, and it will get that charm down.
Oh, this was two jumps already. Patoman is not believing it. This is going really well for him. The Deoxys defense is not getting to the next move. We're going to see a weather ball. This is going to be unshielded. Patoman has finally done it. So many times he's stripped up, but now he wins this.
Patoman is your Gdansk Regional Champion 2024. Give it up for Patoman. We're setting the bracket and then finally winning it. After getting second place twice, he is now the champion.
Patoman, I cannot think of a player who deserves the victory more in all of those tournaments. Three times he has attended in European tournaments. Two times he has been defeated in the grand finals. And now he manages to reverse sweep our previous European international champion, Tonton Batu's, a friend of his, in such a convincing way. 6-2-2.
Tears are flying around. Patoman cannot believe it himself. He won that tournament. Finally, after three times, he got that grand finals in his favor. And Tonton still a very nice second place with Clefable, with Seeking, with Artifacts. That was such a good run for me as well. Such an awesome tournament, Leo. I cannot describe it in any other way. We had the spice. We had the stacked tournament. We had the players. This was perfect.